For Andhra Pradesh, the third National Family Health Survey brought to light some alarming facts. Across the state, among children below the age of 3, 40.4% were underweight, 37.3% had stunted growth, and 82.7% of children were anemic. Among women too, the figures were startling. 37.5% of women had a body mass index below 18.5 kilogram per meter square, and 58.2% of pregnant women were anemic. Clearly, there was a massive need for creative interventions to improve the health of pregnant lactating women and young children. It had been observed that a disturbing cycle existed where pregnant women bore low-weight babies who then grew up stunted, underweight and malnourished, later becoming anemic mothers themselves. Something had to be done to fundamentally alter the projected life cycles of the citizens of Andhra Pradesh. How was the state going to reach out to the stakeholders such as mothers-to-be or lactating mothers with little children in an effective manner? The answer was to take the assistance of the self-help groups. Across the state, over 90 lakh women members formed the 6.3 lakh women SHGs under the Indira Kranti Patham. IKP, as it is popularly called, is a statewide poverty reduction project that aims at enabling and empowering the rural poor through organizations they run themselves. In Andhra Pradesh, women-run self-help groups or SHGs are the cornerstone of the rural development movement and the fight against poverty. These groups are federated from the single SHG at hamlet level to the village level through the village organization, locally called the Gram Samakhya, and then upwards to the mandal level through the Mahila Mandal Samakhya. And then up to the Zilla level through the Zilla Samakhya. Andhra Pradesh alone has about half of SHGs organized in the country. The impact of the SHGs is everywhere to be seen. From being thrift and savings groups, they have grown to become the backbone of women's development activities across the state. Today, 98% of the members make savings regularly. All the groups meet at least once in a month to discuss various social issues related to their day-to-day life. A very high number of the SHG members adopt small family norms. All children of the SHG members can access immunization services against 6 killer childhood diseases. SHG members have access to better cooking fuels, are engaging with local politics, take and repay loans that make their lives better, create extra incomes for their families through various income generating activities, and show a remarkable increase in self-esteem levels, awareness and volunteerism. They are increasingly aware supporters of social equality and fight social evils with the state. In many ways, they are the right hand of the Andhra Pradesh government's rural development aims. The competence and strength of the SHG network became the basis of the new intervention devised for the state, the Community Managed Nutrition Program. With their involvement, the program became a success very soon. On the ground, this program is run through Nutrition Cum Daycare Centers or NDCCs. To understand the importance of the SHG-managed NDCC, let us examine some case studies. Take Kanniamma for instance.
సెంటర్లోకి అందరూ మొత్తం వెళ్ళారు. ఇద్దరు ఒక ఐదుగురు ముగ్గురు అలాగ వెళ్ళేవారు. వెళ్తే నేను వెళ్ళేదాన్ని కాదు సెంటర్కి, బాబు కడుపులో ఉండేటప్పుడు. అంతే, నా బాబు చనిపోయాడు. చనిపోయిన తర్వాత మళ్ళీ ఒక సంవత్సరం ఉన్నారు. అలాగే తర్వాత మళ్ళీ ప్రెగ్నెంట్ అండి రెండో పాపకి. ప్రెగ్నెంట్ అయ్యే తర్వాత సెంటర్లో జాయిన్ అప్పుడు సెంటర్లోకి రానేసి పిలిస్తే వెళ్ళానండి. ఒక వారం అలా తిన్నాను. అక్కడికెళ్ళి ఫుడ్ తినడంలో కొంచెం బాగా అనిపించింది. అందుకు ఫస్ట్లో అలా తిన్నాను.
There are many such stories of lives being directly affected by the community-run NDCCs. In Kannayamma's case, it also changed her husband's attitude.
సెంటర్ కి వెళ్ళకుంటున్నేటప్పుడు మాకు పాలు గుడ్డు ఉండేది కాదు కదా. దానివల్ల మాకు హాస్పిటల్కి వెళ్ళా సరే మీకు బ్లడ్ తక్కువ, ఆరోగ్యమైన శుభ్రంగా తినాలి ఆకుకూరలతో అని ఇంటి దగ్గర అలాగే అవ్వేది కాదండి. అప్పుడు సెంటర్లో జాయిన్ అవ్వండి అని చెప్పారు. చెప్తే మా ఆయన మేము ఎందుకండి మా ఇంటి దగ్గర సరిపోద్ది కదా, మేము ఎందుకు సెంటర్కి పంపించను అనేవాడు. అంటే అలాగా నేను సెంటర్కి వెళ్తాను, నాకు అక్కడే బాగుంటుందేమో ఒకసారి తినిచి వస్తాను అనేసి మా ఆయనతో మాట్లాడామండి. మాట్లాడితే సర్లే వెళ్ళని పంపించారు. అక్కడికి పంపిన తర్వాత ఒక వారం రోజులు అలాగ వెళ్ళి తిన్నానండి. తింటే అక్కడ బాగుందా లేదా అని అడిగితే అక్కడ అంతా బాగుంది, మళ్ళీ నేను సెంటర్కే వెళ్తాను అని చెప్పాను.
బట్ హౌ వాస్ దిస్ అచీవ్డ్? వాట్ ఈస్ డిఫరెంట్ అబౌట్ ది న్యూట్రిషన్ మోడల్ అట్ ఎన్ NDCC? The most significant part of the NDCC model is that it is completely community managed. It is a nutrition program owned and run by the community that aims to ensure a healthy life for both mother and child in the first 1000 days of their existence. It has two clear purposes. The first is the steady provision of three nutritionally balanced meals every day to all pregnant lactating women and children between the ages of 6 months and 3 years. The second is to become a venue for behavior change communication, health education and social interaction between members. In other words, all members eat three balanced nutritional meals at the center and are exposed to health related information and discussions while they are there. Since the information provided comes from peers, it is well received and assimilated. Every NDCC aims to foster fundamental behavior change that leads to better health and nutritional habits among beneficiaries, even when they are no longer members. Today, there are 1800 NDCCs in 22 districts of Andhra Pradesh. A majority of these centers are developed in villages where marginalized and SC/ST communities live. At this NDCC in a village near Visakhapatnam, expectant and lactating mothers are given information that improves the chances of both mother and child surviving the first years before and after pregnancy. Every village member is able to pay and access nutritious meals. The cost at just rupees 10 is lower than the cost they would have to spend eating at home. Even here, they are helped at the NDCC since they can participate in common interest group income generating activities like sewing, making leaf plates, paper covers, spice packaging, preparation of papads, painting, printing on saris, making of baskets and more. These activities provide enough remuneration to pay for the cost of the meals as well as provide an earning of rupees 25 to 50 for the member. Every NDCC is also encouraged to have a community kitchen garden which helps lower the cost of nutritional meals. Through the village organization, they are also able to access low-cost supplies under the public distribution system. In this way, NDCC becomes steadily self-reliant. One may be prompted to ask, where does the initial capital to begin a NDCC come from? When a new NDCC opens, a one-time grant of 2.5 lakhs is given to the village organization. In addition, a sum of 50,000 is provided to set things up. Cooking utensils, rent, cost of employing a cook, kitchen garden, toys and baby food. A further sum of 50,000 is provided towards training and support for the village organization. Capacity building is a vital part of the initial process, since the state remains directly involved in a NDCC for only about a year. During this time, SHG and VO members gain the required skills to manage the entire program. After the hand-holding stage, every NDCC is expected to manage its program and raise funds to remain sustainable. Till date, the model has worked everywhere, even after the withdrawal of state support, because the community sees the value of the NDCC. Musalli Devi is a farmer. When she was expecting her first baby, she heard about the nutritional program at NDCC and decided to join, since she could not afford the right diet at home. She found the women in her SHG very supportive during her pregnancy. She was able to deliver a healthy baby without spending any money. Today she knows how to look after her baby better and takes the child for checkups to the NDCC and the doctor. She also recommends NDCC to her friends and people who need help.
ఇంతకు ముందు అంటే మేము మా అమ్మగారు బాగా పేదవాళ్ళం. పాలు గుడ్డు డైలీ ఇవ్వలేరు. అందువల్ల ఇలా సెంటర్కి వెళ్తే డైలీ ఇస్తారని సెంటర్కి వెళ్ళేవారు. దానివల్ల నా ఆరోగ్యం, బేబీ ఆరోగ్యం కూడా చాలా ఆరోగ్యం తాని అంటే హాస్పిటల్లో తానికులు అవి ఇస్తారు. ఇక్కడ సెంటర్లో పాలు అవి ఇస్తారు బేబీకి పట్టమని అవి కూడా పడతాం.
NDCCs are crucial to overall rural development, since they introduce certain universal and intensive interventions at the village level. These universal interventions include 1. The introduction of a fixed nutrition and health day, where regular monitoring and social auditing becomes possible. 2. The creation of a community fund for health emergencies. 3. Generating interest and awareness of health insurance services. 4. Regular training and capacity building. And 5. The creation of community or backyard gardens to supplement nutrition. Intensive interventions include 1. The running of an active community-managed nutrition center with the clear aim to reach Millennium Development Goals for maternal and child health. And 2. The promotion of better sanitation and water facilities in every village. It is important to note here that none of this would be possible without the active support and involvement of women from SHGs. Their role makes every NDCC a site for the operation of many of the rural development programs.